I misgendered you at the start of the conversation by accident, and you're a good friend of mine. Can you walk us through what your pronoun preferences are and how that works exactly?
I identify as non-binary or genderqueer. I have been gender non-conforming since I was, as long as I can remember. I've got pictures of me from when I was super, super young, and I was really androgynous. And it's been something that I have struggled with for most of my life. And it's just now that I have finally felt comfortable and felt like I've had the space to really be public as my authentic self and claim that space as being a non-binary person. So for me, non-binary is, I don't identify as like man, I don't identify as woman, I identify as somewhere in between.
Have you faced any kind of backlash or any negativity or any, has it been a source of stress or has it just been all sunshine and roses in triathlon?
So there have been a couple of articles that have come out and interviews that have come out and the response has been overwhelmingly positive, especially to me personally. Some of the comments on social media have been quite negative. However, the comments that are made are like nothing I haven't heard before. A lot of it is stemmed in, I would like to say a more gentler word than ignorance, but it is a little bit about ignorance and just like not super understanding the sort of the complexities between gender, sex and gender. Just because I identify as non-binary doesn't mean that like I am on hormones or that I am changing my body in any way. I haven't taken those comments, those negative comments personally. I'm still using a lot of energy to correct everyone on pronouns right now. And you know, I would love to be having those conversations on social media of like addressing some of that negativity and just helping people see that we are just all human and that I'm not a threat and that everybody has a right to their own identity.
There's a constant input of energy for queer people. Even if you're immersed in this relatively accepting community like triathlon, there's just a long series of decisions you have to make in every interaction about how you want to present yourself, what people need to know. And so for me, it might be a little bit different than your experience, but you know, I can pass pretty easily for straight if I choose to. So then every time I travel, like, is it worth coming out to my Uber driver in Monterrey, Mexico, when he asks if I have a girlfriend back home? You know, there's this, a long series, for example, of events like that. And I have to, it just takes a constant input of energy, I find, to work, just to navigate that kind of pathway. And I also hear you about like a level of ignorance in triathlon. I love the sport, but by and large, it's a predominantly homogeneous sport, I would say, with a lot of white people, upper class people from kind of a very narrow segment of society. And that's changing. I think it's becoming a more global sport. It's becoming more accessible to other people. And I love to see that. But I think a lot of people just maybe haven't been exposed to a broader range of diversity like we might see in other communities. And I do see some really positive changes in that regard through athletes like you, Rach, who are just being more visible in their differences. And I think it's awesome.
Yeah, I agree. I think we're awesome too. And even as a younger athlete, what a difference it would have made if there were more out athletes or if there was another professional athlete who identified as non-binary. Like, how much of a difference would that have made in terms of me being able to, you know, be my most authentic self earlier in life? And that's what's really motivating and inspiring for me, is recognizing that there are likely for both of us a lot of young queer athletes out there, or athletes who have different gender identities, who see us and may not feel like they have a voice or a place in the sport, but because there are other folks out there being super open and being out there, that it acts as an inspiration for them to have the confidence to participate in sport.